less than 100 miles away, Cuba is one of the United States' closest neighbors. Yet we know very little about this island. After the United States and Cuba split in the 1950s, almost no new information has been communicated, so what we think of Cuba has become outdated. Cuba is still seen by many Americans as a dark, shady country to live in. In our short visit, we have discovered the truth behind lies and propaganda. And while no place is perfect, we have found a beautiful city filled with gorgeous scenery, friendly people, bountiful culture, and most importantly, a never-ending love for music. Welcome to Havana, Cuba. Cuba is the largest of the Greater Antilles Islands and is also the most beautiful. Its shoreline spans more than 3,000 miles and has more than 280 natural beaches. As you move inland, one will find the city of Havana, the capital of the Republic of Cuba. It has nearly 3 million inhabitants and is by far the largest city on the island. Painted in faded pastel colors, these aging buildings make up the majority of the cityscape in Havana. Another architectural majesty is El Museo de la Revolución, which used to be the presidential palace. You can still see the bullet holes in the walls when it was stormed by revolutionaries. The rest of the building is a testament to the opulence of the former regime and the story of the current regime's rise to power.
Pedroso family, Spanish family, later American family living here. Now a hotel, only 10 rooms. It's very nice. And Cuba now, big business for Chinese. Look at the bus, Chinese bus.
Misconceptions about the people of Cuba usually start with the mistaken identity of what life is like under a communist government. Americans believe that people scurry about with their heads down, afraid to meet or talk to foreigners, lest they feel the repercussions of their actions. The people we met throughout Cuba could not be happier to talk with us. They shared food, friends, and photos, and would appreciate anything in return.
La música cubana es el corazón de los cubanos.
Sí.
La música cubana, como pueden ver, es la tradición de nosotros desde chiquitos. Porque procedemos de los africanos, que empieza de la raíz de la música afrocubana hasta llegar a la salsa. Y nosotros los cubanos la llevamos en la sangre. Los cubanos nosotros le entregamos el corazón. Nosotros somos amigos para toda la vida. No amigos por un peso ni amigos, no amigos para toda la vida. Yo soy un muchacho estudiador acá con mi amiga. ¿Me entiendes? Un muchacho que estudia acá. Y si el día de mañana los vuelvo a ver, quiero que sean mis amigos otra vez. ¿Me entiendes? Quiero que sean mis amigos otra vez. Acá tienen la suerte, a ver si ustedes, después que conozcan esto.
So he's saying that that it's really important to come out here and see what's really actually Cuban, not like La Floridita and all the like touristy things and what Americans and tourists perceive as Cuba, but to come here and to other places that are truly the heart of Cuba. And he's saying that we're going to be friends because we've met each other, and that we're not just friends because of money, and this isn't just like he's not helping us out just because he wants us to like tip him or something, because he wants us to understand his country and to appreciate his country for what it really is, and that we are really lucky to all have met each other here, and that we're going to have a really wonderful experience from going out and seeing places like this. So
it's very good. I love you, United States.
Come on here. Come on.
This is kind of like a primary religious part of the city where people come to, like the kids come here to learn how to dance and how to practice the faith.
Our lovely enemies, welcome here.
Hola.
Our frenemies.
Frenemies.
Time to realize this. Well, I disagree with this definition that people do it. It's just a mixture between Catholicism and African religion from Nigeria. But for me, Santeria is just a way of interaction with the Orishas. Orishas are natural forces, the fire, the thunder, the wind. Ori means head, deity that lives in your head. That means that you have your own energy. That energy is in communion with one natural force, that is your Orisha, your God, that you have to give offerings to receive your positive things in order to fulfill your destiny that has been given by the Almighty.
Se tocan instrumentos y por qué se tocan la música aquí.
¿O por qué la tocamos nosotros?
Ajá.
Bueno, a mí yo sin la música no puedo vivir. La música, de hecho, toco aquí, toco en mi casa, toco en actividades donde quiera, porque me gusta. La música va en el cubano, eso es una cosa.
Sí, la sangre.
La sangre.
Sí.
Eso es de por vida. Desde que tenía, no sé, 10, 12 años. Me gustó la percusión y siempre toqué la percusión.
Wow. ¿Y por qué eligieron sus instrumentos? ¿Por qué la guitarra y los bongos?
En mi caso, la percusión siempre me llamó la atención. Hacer hacer bulla. Yo toco el bongo, toco la paila, toco la tumbadora.
Muy bien.
Maraca, güiro, todo lo.
Wow.
Sí, yo toco la percusión casi completa.
Wow, increíble.
Y me gustaba los ritmos, los espacios.
Yo también.
Ver, toco rumba el día 31, es decir, el fin de año.
Sí.
Yo me pasé desde las 12 de la noche del año nuevo hasta las 4 de la madrugada tocando rumba.
Wow.
En la calle, aquí en Cuba se toca donde quiera.
Dios
en la
mío.
Calle, tocando en la calle.
Wow, qué bonito. ¿Y saben por qué la guitarra?
A mí lo que me gusta es la percusión.
Ajá.
Bueno, la guitarra, no sé, tal vez la tenía la sangre y ya la cogí, ya.
Sí. Aprendí
solo, yo no fui a escuela.
Wow, qué bueno, qué bueno. Y la música de aquí de Cuba es un parte de la sangre, pero la clave, podemos, ustedes pueden hablar sobre la clave y cómo es un aspecto de la música, un elemento.
Sin la clave no se puede hacer nada. Uh-huh. Todo está, ya lo dice, es una clave.
Sí. Cubana es su favorito.
A mí la música tradicional, uh-huh, esta que hacemos nosotros, como uh-huh, el chanchan, lágrimas negras, para mí música tradicional. En general oigo mucha música, uh-huh, porque sé tocar jazz, me gusta el jazz, uh-huh, me gusta mucho la música americana de los años 80, 90, uh-huh, me encanta, pero lo que más yo siento es la música tradicional cubana.
Musicians are common sights throughout Havana. Every store, every restaurant, every street has musicians smiling and playing for customers and pedestrians. Walking from one street corner to the next, one will come across musicians performing the styles of salsa, rumba, and changui. It is not only a way of making their restaurant welcome and inviting, but it is, to some extent, a cultural necessity. Music and dance are irrevocably intertwined in Cuban culture. Everywhere there was music, people were dancing, and we were always welcome to hop in. While many shied away from the opportunity, the more advanced Latin dancers among us jumped right in. Fortunately, for the rest of us, there was a Latin dance class offered during the week. La Tropicana can be considered the height of music and dance in many ways. What started as an American mobsters club has become a major tourism draw and features some of the most talented people in the country. The show was one of the highlights of our stay in Cuba, as we saw many fascinating dancers and heard wonderful songs. We approached Cuba apprehensively, not knowing quite what to expect. Our brains were full of the aforementioned misconceptions. However, as we spent our week, we came to see the true Cuba, the friends, the music, the food. Although our time in Cuba was short, we will never forget the kindness shown to us and the fun we had.
That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. Good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night.